time I ever met Mimi was in the winter of 1971. I was flying gliders then some, and I had heard of this magical place in Colorado called Black Forest Gliderport. I just had to go there, so I took my week of vacation from Sears between Christmas and New Year's, when we didn't do anything in the plumbing department anyway, and went up there. Didn't call ahead or anything like that, and arrived to find they were having a wave camp, they called it. That was where they flew in the mountain wave off of Pike's Peak. And they said, well, you aren't in the camp, but we'll try to work you in. So in the next couple of days, I got my wave orientation flight and checked out to fly their airplane or their gliders and all of that. And then one morning they said, okay, you're going to be the first to go to the mountain this morning. They hooked me up, and that was the wildest ride I have ever been on. And in anything, airplane, glider, anything else, and I was so lost that when I got off tow, the rate of climb just pegged out, and you could even look at the ground and see you were climbing like crazy. And we got up above 30,000 feet, and I was trying to remember how high they said to go, but all I could remember is they said, don't go above 32,000 feet. So when I hit that, I pulled the spoilers and came back down.
It's good to be back. Our oxygen mask is already discarded in anticipation of a meal in the Black Forest kitchen. Soup's on, literally. Mimi's dishing up one of her famous creations. Some folks may fill out the meal with things they've cooked using the clubhouse facilities.
And I found, after they calibrated the barograph trace and all that, I'd been from release at about 13,000 feet to 32,000 feet and back to the ground in 47 minutes. I wrote an article about that, and it's in my website. But at any rate, that trip up there was where I first met Mimi. She was a lady with a strong French accent, and she made some fantastic soup there that we had each day at noon. And I'm going to try to duplicate her soup now. You start out with a pot with some water in it on the stove and letting it get hot. And you add some chicken to it. Now this is some chicken thighs that I found for 99 cents a pound at Kroger's, and so I bought three of them, and that ought to be enough for this pot of soup. And I always heard you were supposed to wash chicken before you use it, and then the latest thing has been don't wash it, because all you'll do is scatter any germs that might be on it. Around the kitchen. There it is. And we're going to use some seasoning here. Season the water. First thing is the bottom of an onion that you would normally cut off and throw away. It has the strongest flavor in it. And so no use to waste that. And three or four bay leaves. And let that come up to a simmer, and we're going to cook it for about an hour till it gets where it'll come off the bone and we can turn it into stock and cut the meat up. Okay, it's been about an hour now, and this is cooked until it's tender. So now what we will do is skin it and remove the bones and things like that that we don't really want in the soup. That all goes in the garbage bowl over there. Tear the meat off the bone here. And we'll return the meat to the stock, and I'll finish this up. Okay, got all the meat off the bones here, and picked the bay leaves out of it and everything like that, and the onion bottom, and everything goes back in the stock, and this is the garbage bowl here. Now next we go with the vegetables that are going in there. Okay, everything is separated on the meat, and the meat's in here, and the bones and skin and whatnot's in the garbage. And I was at Kroger's and going through the vegetable department to pick out what I wanted to put in the vegetables in this. And incidentally, that was Mimi's job in the French Underground, was to go out and scratch around deserted gardens and farm patches and see if she could find vegetables and maybe find a farm animal of some kind to make soup with. And she was less noticeable as a 15-year-old girl than she would have been, as it would have been a man out there. But anyway, their job was to rescue escaped prisoners and downed airmen and stuff like that, and either get them to where they could come in with a small airplane and fly them out, or get them to the shore where they could get on a boat back to England. But anyway, I was in Kroger's and looking through there, and the only thing I'd found so far that I wanted was a zucchini. And the vegetable manager was there and kind of looking at me, and I said, I'm buying vegetables. I want one at a time of most things to make a big pot of soup. And he said, well, here. And he showed me this, and this is a pot roast blend, they call it, and it's already got most of them cut to size and everything, so that was the easy way to handle that, and that's what I'm going to use here. So now I'll fix these vegetables and toss them in the pot. Well, the celery here looked a little bit big for individual bites, so I'm going to cut it in two. Here's onions, they're about the right size, as are the carrots. Potatoes I'm going to have to cut up. Well, everything else in there looks about the right size. I'll just dump it in and go with that. Cut the potatoes here into bite-sized pieces. I'll finish these up now. Okay, the vegetables are all in there. Now some garlic. Can't ever have too much garlic. I'm just gonna lace it pretty good with some salt. It won't be too much, I'm sure. I'll have to add some later. And I'm just going to use boxed stock to come up and cover the vegetables in there. Now I'm going to turn the burner back on and bring it up to a simmer and let it cook the vegetables. Well, it's been simmering for a while now. First thing I want to do is check it for salt. It could use some more. You know, when the war was over, the Vichy government, which is sort of like the swamp here in the U.S., it's mostly bureaucrats and whatnot like that, took charge of, incidentally, this is some mushrooms here that I had and used them out. I didn't want to put them in with the other vegetables because they cooked too quickly. But anyway, the Vichy government sent out orders to arrest all the members of the resistance. In fact, they were going to execute some of them. And this colonel who had been rescued by that particular group that Mimi was with, been rescued by them and gotten back to England somehow. But the war was over, so he went over there and hunted her up and then sneaked her aboard an Air Force airplane, bringing her back to the U.S. so she wouldn't get arrested and jailed and maybe even executed. And she sort of grew up there, then came out and got a job at the Gliderport cleaning the Lenny Inn, which is a little four-unit motel, cleaning the bunkhouse and the which had eight bunks in it, and cleaning the clubhouse. And she just started making soup every Saturday for the crew and anybody else that was there. And also during wave camps in the winter, she would make soup every day. And that's how I got acquainted with her. But she was a neat lady and had quite a history, and it was my honor and pleasure to have met her and knew her while she was alive. The Gliderport closed in 87, and about 5 years after that she passed away. She lived in just about a quarter mile north of the Gliderport. Check these here. I think that is soup. We're going to have some of that for dinner. Okay, let's see how this tastes. That's good soup. How does it taste to you, hon?
Good as usual.
Well, I'm going to enjoy my bowl of soup here. Mimi had a saying about soup. Good sex gets a man, good soup keeps him. So, with that in mind, God bless America, God bless Texas, because what other state could you find a picture like this? Bye.